I'm making this video as a video response to Elmify's room tour, and I'm not going to do a room tour because it's a mess right now, but I'm going to do, she talked about her collections and how she likes to collect stuff, and I like to do that too. So it's her fault that I'm exposing my crazy to the internet, because people who come into my room usually know me and also know that I'm crazy about Alice in Wonderland. And you'll see now that I have several editions of the book and some figurines. Be warned, I am a collector of Alice things. It's your fault, Elmify. Alright, this is my Alice in Wonderland shelf. This is a Christmas ornament that has never been in a tree. This is a thing that I bought in a Disney store in Chicago. It has a thing here so that you can put a wish inside. I have not wished for anything yet. I went through a lot of packages trying to feel what kind of figurine was inside, until I thought maybe that was Alice. This has an excellent smell. I'm so sorry you can't smell this. I've had this since I was like 8, and I had never paid attention to it because of that ugly drawing in the cover. If anyone can explain to me why this is in 3D. Yeah, this is a scam, and I fell for it. I don't know why they would include Alice's sister. I think Alice was one. Oh yeah. Yep, yep. This. I can't remember where I got. Why would you dress Alice like that? There's a porcupine with an ice cream for some reason. I love this edition. It's like vintage. That looks like Pride and Prejudice. I remember buying this because I thought it was hilarious how they colored the choosing of the colors in the cover. This one is from 1964. This is a true pocket book.